This is why you sometimes wake up in the middle of the night and can't move. Imagine this. You go to bed after a regular day, just like you do every night. Then, sometime after midnight, your eyes open. You know you're awake because you can feel, hear, and see everything the same way you did before you fell asleep. But slowly, you realize something's off. Your mind is awake, but you can't move. It feels like there's something crushing your chest. That's when panic sets in, and you realize you're awake in a nightmare. This sounds like something straight out of a Stephen King novel, but it's actually a phenomenon that happens to a lot of people. In fact, being awake in a nightmare is the most common way people describe this condition, along with waking up dead. Sleep paralysis, as it's commonly known, has puzzled every culture around the world for hundreds of years. People from all around the world have described this condition and could only provide spiritual and esoteric explanations. Today, with the help of science, we have a deeper understanding of what it means. Before we begin this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more daily tips like this, and turn on notifications so you never miss our new videos. So, what is it exactly? Thanks to modern research, we now know that sleep paralysis originates from issues with REM sleep. During REM sleep, the body gets frozen by the brain in order to stop you from physically acting out your dreams while you're asleep. This kind of paralysis that happens during REM sleep is natural and normal, called REM atonia. It becomes unnatural when a person is awake while their body is experiencing that REM atonia. It sounds pretty horrifying, doesn't it? If you've ever experienced sleep paralysis, you're probably well aware of how scary it can be, and how it can have a huge impact on the way you live your everyday life. In fact, most people who suffer from sleep paralysis often experience lack of sleep because the thought of experiencing it makes them want to avoid sleeping altogether. It may also affect their mental health as well as their physical health as they try to navigate through their daily lives with a sleep schedule that is often severely affected or non-existent at all. Now, here is some more information about sleep paralysis that you should know. Number 1. What causes sleep paralysis? Basically, anything that messes up the REM stage of your sleeping. Things like jet lag, lack of sleep, irregular sleep patterns, or migraines can cause it. On top of that, psychological factors can also trigger sleep paralysis. This includes anxiety disorders, overwhelming stress, trauma, or alcohol, and substance abuse. There are many different things which can bring about an episode of sleep paralysis. For example, sleep deprivation can lead to sleep paralysis, while certain medications can trigger sleep paralysis as well. Studies also state that sleep paralysis can be genetic, and that it is more likely to happen to people who are between the ages of 10 and 25 years old. Studies also state that people who suffer from depression or anxiety are much more likely to experience sleep paralysis. In fact, 31.9% of people who suffer from mental disorders also experience sleep paralysis. Keep watching for some even more interesting information about sleep paralysis. Number 2. What are the symptoms of sleep paralysis? There are many different symptoms associated with sleep paralysis. When a person is suffering a sleep paralysis episode, they experience symptoms which can range from the inability to breathe to a feeling of dread or even horror. When a person wakes up during an episode, he or she is usually unable to move his or her body. The person is also usually unable to speak. These symptoms can last for as long as 2 minutes. Another symptom a person who is suffering from an episode may experience is a choking feeling or a heavy feeling on their chest. Patients who experience this describe being awake and just knowing that what they are experiencing is not a dream. It can last from a few seconds to several minutes. People who wake up to sleep paralysis can perceive their environment and everything in it without any sort of brain fog. Immediately, they realize they can't move. Sleep paralysis doesn't have any side effects on the brain, and it is not harmful, but it causes an extreme amount of fear and dread once the person realizes they can't move. The experience of being trapped inside your own body makes people think that they are dying, or that there's some type of supernatural force at work. Some people describe a crawling, an electrifying sensation running up and down their body. The experience of sleep paralysis can be so shocking to a person that they start hallucinating and experiencing things that they can't control or properly react to. According to the Sleep Paralysis Project, the most common hallucinations reported by people include doors opening, animals growling, approaching footsteps, scratching, and malevolent whispering. All of these symptoms can have quite a big psychological effect on a person, making a person who suffers from sleep paralysis afraid to go to sleep, and even frightened of sleeping alone. What can I do if I suffer from sleep paralysis? 7.6% of the general population has experienced some kind of issue with sleep paralysis. If you suffer from sleep paralysis, you should speak to your doctor immediately. Although there is no form of treatment for sleep paralysis, there are many different types of preventative measures as well as forms of treatment for certain underlying causes which are causing the sleep paralysis. If you begin to experience the symptoms associated with sleep paralysis, make sure that your sleep schedule is balanced and that you're getting enough sleep every night. You should also try to avoid alcohol, drugs, and nicotine at night. You should try to avoid these things at least 3 hours before going to bed. Another thing you should do if you begin to experience sleep paralysis is avoid drinking caffeine after 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Most don't know it, but drinking coffee after a certain time of day can have a huge effect on certain people, affecting how they sleep, the quality of their sleep, and when they fall asleep. They should also avoid using electronics before going to sleep and keep them out of your bedroom. Using electronics before bed can disrupt your circadian rhythm, which can also have a huge effect on your sleep cycle. Your circadian rhythm is a 24-hour cycle, generally referred to as a body clock. It is a cycle in our bodies that tell us when to sleep, wake up, and eat. This internal clock regulates many of your body's physiological processes and can be affected by many different things. When our circadian rhythm is disrupted, our sleep patterns and cycles can become severely affected. A disrupted circadian rhythm can also affect a person's eating patterns. This is why it is important to keep your body clock in check, as it can have a huge impact on our health and our everyday lives. If your sleep paralysis continues and is starting to have an effect on your life, work, and relationships with friends or family members, consult with your doctor or sleep specialist to find out what may be causing your sleep paralysis. A sleep specialist can help identify any underlying causes and can also help you take preventative measures to ensure it doesn't happen again. What are some other things people might experience while experiencing sleep paralysis? Let us know by commenting below. Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button and share with your friends. Also, subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.